Ladies and gentlemen, David Cassidy.
Why, thank you.
Actually, there's a link there because you yourself have been photographed by Terry O'Neill.
I have indeed. I'm surprised that we haven't used it. Did we not can we pull that picture out? Oh, well.
Just making life very complicated then. Can we talk a little bit about your past? I know you get very tired talking about your past. That's what everybody
We can talk a little bit about my past, sure.
But you were phenomenally successful at a very, very young age. What made you give up?
I think being phenomenally successful probably made me give up. I think the price that I had to pay for that kind of fame and that kind of success really made me give it up. I think that I lost, as Terry started to give me a great link or lead into, I think I lost a great deal of my own identity. I think I perpetuated the image. They perpetuated, and I certainly assisted.
Because you were at many times almost a virtual prisoner, weren't you? Mm-hmm. I was reading that you were locked in your hotel room. You didn't really have very much company. You had to be guarded for your own safety. And in fact, I came to your concert last night, and even now, 10 years later, mm-hmm. there were girls getting up on the stage and having to be dragged off.
You were one of them too, may I say? Yeah, it's it's very interesting now that coming back after 10 years to see that There are a lot of young fans, and there are a lot of fans that have been around and have been fans of mine for 10, 11, 12 years. And they're all in it and rocking. I don't think there's really any hysteria any longer, but I do think that it's still very intense, and they're great fans.
Now, how's your attitude changed? Are you enjoying now touring more than you did before?
Well, yes, I'm enjoying... I'm enjoying the whole experience a whole lot more. I'm enjoying making the records. I'm enjoying writing. I think that my attitude about it has certainly changed, and I've matured. But I think that the audience has assisted me in that respect.
Yes.
You were at the concert last night. I mean, you saw that I was having a good time.
You really were. But I mean, you used to play gigs the size of Wembley Stadium, White City Stadium, stadiums all over the world.
Right.
And now you're doing 19 dates in the UK, really, really much smaller.
Oh,
gigs.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Well, do you mind that, or do you find that in a way more personal?
No, it's much. I don't mind playing the smaller gigs. As a matter of fact, in the old days, what used to be very frustrating is that. There was very little rapport between myself and an audience of 60, 70,000 people. And when you're playing to 2,500 or 3,500 people, everybody is a part of it. And that's what the experience is about, that exchange.
You really, I noticed last night, you give an awful lot of yourself to
well,
audience. Does it drain you completely? Do you feel completely exhausted?
I feel pretty relatively wiped out, yeah. I feel... because I love it, and because I enjoy it, and because it's all coming back to me, I have no alternative. I've also been training rather hard for this, so I'm glad I did, I'm glad
it's lovely talking to you, but we can't deny the audience something of your voice, which is a lovely voice. What are you going to do for us?
I'm going to sing a song. Actually, I'm not going to sing a song. No, I'm kidding. I'm going to sing a song that I do in the show. It's one of my... earlier hits, as opposed to coming here and plugging one of my recent ones. It's called I'm a Clown.
Whenever you're around, coming down. He knows what I know. If you look inside, if I didn't hide, you might decide. You don't want me. Clown, I'll look at the clown, clown, just like that fool on the hill. Yeah, I'm begging to come down. I wanna live again. Oh, I wanna feel. Tell me you love me.
Could you bring